Good morning, class. Today our experiment is to find the center of gravity of a given wooden block using the two methods, that is the parallel force apparatus and the geometrical method.
Now we will first of all define what is center of gravity. A center of gravity may be defined as a point where the resultant of all the forces acting on the body are found to be or said to be concentrated. Today our experiment is to find out the center of gravity of a given wooden block. This is our given wooden block. We have this wooden block with a figure from forming with four sides A, B, A, C, C, D and B, D. Also we have three holes in it, hole number 1, 2 and 3. We need to find the center of gravity of this block using two methods. Out of these, there are two methods. First method is to use the parallel force apparatus. This is our parallel force apparatus. Here we will place this block on this beam. Now center of gravity of a point for this block can be found out by this method. In this method we will place the object or this block using the edge AB first. We have placed this object on this parallel beam. Now we will define a certain distance as prescribed by our teacher, that is our A distance from A edge. This is our A distance. We can measure it using our ruler scale. We will now also note down the reactions of these two springs. We can adjust these springs to zero value using this side knob, and we can note down the reactions RA and RB. Now we will proceed and we will place this wooden block along the other side, that is perpendicular to this side. This is AC side. Now we will again have another distance B. This distance can be also be given by the teacher or can be taken as another distance from A, that is already when we used. Now we will again note down the reactions RA and RB. Now we will use these reactions and calculate the moment about any point. For example, this is our one point or second point. We will use the moment equation. That moment equation is
W into A plus X is equals to RB into L, where RB is the reaction of the B point and L is the length of this whole beam.
W into A plus X, W is the weight of this block, A is this distance and X is the distance that is from this side of X of AB edge. For this is this edge AB. This is the X distance, that is the center of gravity in the X direction of this block. Now we will again calculate for the Y coordinate that we have calculated along the AC edge. This is the center of gravity point from another edge, from this edge, that is from AC edge. Now we will again use the moment equation for Y coordinate, that is W into B plus Y is equals to RB into L. RB is the reaction, L is the whole length, B is this distance and Y is the coordinate for center of gravity for this side. Now we have these two coordinates X and Y. Now we will use a graph paper. We will trace this block on the graph paper and mark these X and Y coordinates along the X and Y coordinates along the AB edge and the AC edge. This is our first part of the experiment, that is finding out the center of gravity of this block using the parallel force apparatus. We can do this experiment using the bolts also and without the bolts also. We can have these bolts also placed like this. Now we will have again another reactions value. We will have different CG points for this block. So we can have two methods for solving this. Now, as we have discussed earlier, that was the method of finding out the center of gravity of this point of this block using the parallel force apparatus. Now that was the first method. Now the second method is by using the centroid or the geometrical method of finding the center of gravity of this block for a prescribed number of bolts fitted in it as given by the teacher. For example, we have this block, we have these four coordinates A, B, C and D. We will trace it on a graph paper. I will show a large view of this block here. Now we have this block A, B, C and D as traced on the graph paper. Now we will try to find out the centroid of this block or figure using the geometrical coordinate method. In this method, we will first divide this block into two triangles. We can do this by drawing a diagonal across A, D. We have joined this. Now we have two triangles A, C, D and A, B, D. We will now try to find out the centroid for these two triangles. The centroid for these two triangles are J and K. These J and K have the coordinates x1 and y1 and K have x2 and y2. This is our three holes that we have, 1, 2 and 3. How we can find out these J and K coordinates? We can find out this by using the midpoint method. In this, we will divide the two sides into two parts, equal parts, and we will join them with the opposite coordinate that we have. For example, in this we have this D point, we have the opposite side as CA. We will divide it into two and we have the midpoint as E. Same we have in this side also, C is the edge and AD is the side opposite to it, and we will divide into two parts, that is AG and GD. So we have this G point as the midpoint. Now as we have this midpoint intersection point as J, this is the centroid for this triangle for ADC. Similarly, we will do this method for second triangle, that is ABD. We will divide it into two midsections that we have early found for AD edge. We will again do it for the AB edge, and the point found is F point. We will join these points and we will have the centroid of this triangle as K, whose coordinates are x2 and y2. Now we also have the coordinates for these circles also, that are the holes in this block, that are 1, 2 and 3. The coordinates for these circles are, for 1 are x3, y3, for 2 are x4, y4 and for 3 are x5, y5. Now, we will try to find out the weightage of these two triangles and the two circles. The two triangles can be, weightage can be found out by the formula that M1 is the weightage of ADC triangle and M2 is the weightage of triangle ABD. Now, M1 can be found out by this formula, that is AD into CI divided by 2. AD is the edge, this edge, and CI is the perpendicular distance of perpendicular for drawn from C to the AD edge. Now we have this weightage of this triangle as half base into height, that is AD into CI divided by 2. Similarly, for ABD triangle, we have the weightage M2 as AD into BH divided by 2. We will draw a perpendicular from B point to H. Now we have the weightage of the triangle ABD as AD into BH divided by 2. So we have the weightage of these two triangles. Now the weightage of the holes can be found out by area of the circle, that is pi d square divided by 4, where d is the dia of these holes or the dia of this hole A1. All these dia are same, so we will take them as D. Now we will find out the centroid for this whole figure using the formula x is equals to x1 into m1 plus x2 into m2 minus sine into my m3 into my x3 plus x4 plus x5 divided by m. Now we will see that there is a negative sign three circles 1, 2 and 3. This is because their contribution in this diagram is negative, or they are not in this block, as we can see that these holes are hollow. So we will use a negative sign for these coordinates x3, x4 and x5 and y3, y4 and y5 for finding out the centroid for this block. Similarly, we can use this same formula for finding out the y coordinates for centroid for this block by using the formula y is equals to y1 into m1 plus y2 into m2 minus m3 into y4 plus y5 plus y3 divided by m. So we have this centroid for this whole block now, that is small x and small y. Now we will use this xy coordinates for finding out the center of gravity of this block, of this given block. This can be found out by using the formula that if we assume that the weight of this block is W, that is the weight of this wooden block, and the assume that the weight of this single bolt that we have here, this is the single bolt, this is the weight of the single bolt, we will measure it, and what is the weight of this bolt, we will measure it, we will denote it by WB. We have a certain weight of it, WB. So now we will use the formula for finding out the coordinates for x and y for center of gravity of this block when there are certain number of fitted blocks in it. For example, if we have one bolt fitted in this block, so we will use a negative sign for these two bolts and a positive sign for this bolt, as it is contributing some weight to this block. So we will use the formula that x is equals to W of the weight of the block
into x
plus W, that is the weight of the bolt, into x3 plus x4 plus x5 divided by weight of this whole block, whole setup, that is W. Now W is the weight of this wooden block plus bolts that are contributing to it. Similarly, we will do this for finding out the y coordinate, that is the other side coordinate, that is this side coordinate. Formula can again be used, that is y is equals to W
into y,
weight of the wooden block plus weight of the bolt, into y3 plus y4 plus y5 divided by W. Now the positive signs for these x3, x4 and x5 and y3, y4 and y5 for finding out the center of gravity of this wooden block can be taken as positive or negative. If they are contributing, then the sign is positive. If they are not contributing, then their sign is negative. So we can use these two formulas to finding out the coordinates x and y using the geometrical method finding out the center of gravity of this block. So these two are the methods that we can use for finding out the center of gravity of this wooden block by having certain number of bolts fitted to it in the given holes 1, 2 and 3. We will compare these two methods by calculating the error in these two methods, that is the parallel force apparatus. We have a certain x value and the geometrical method, we have the x value. We will compare these two values and we will note down the errors for x as well as y coordinate, and we will draw these coordinates on the x and y on the graph paper using the trace paper or the graph paper, and we will have the coordinates for this block.